screen with lightning speed. He's one of the fastest. At 6'5", he's one of the biggest. Does college football's best player wear green? With lightning speed, he's one of the fastest. At 6'5", he's one of the biggest. Add his big play ability, and Randy Moss might be college football's best. His highlight film season includes 22 touchdowns on 83 catches. His next challenge, lead Marshall to a MAC championship. Tonight, the Toledo Rockets try to stop a legend, and Randy Moss is on center stage.
The game's on the line, and you're looking at a full count with 0.2 seconds left on the shot clock. Last thing you need to be worried about is your deodorant. That's why I use Old Spice. Old Spice is the bare-knuckle, straight-arm tackle, heavyweight deodorant that gives the best game, set, and match, high-step and sudden-death double overtime performance in the pit fight against odor.
Safe!
From odor. Thanks, Old Spice.
You won't see them prancing in the end zone or preening for the cameras. Nope. They're too busy defending their turf and sometimes wearing it. All in the name of protecting the quarterback, the offensive lineman. Guys like Nasty, Stink, Jumbo, and Jimbo. State Farm salutes the centers, the guards, the tackles. Because we know there's no substitute for great protection.
The marathon was the hardest thing I've ever done. But remember, pain is temporary and quitting lasts forever. You want to feed the warrior?
What?
Feed the warrior 20 pounds! You feed the warrior by training the body to respond to the mind.
Yeah, I was thinking of maybe just getting into a little light cardio, so.
Hey, Kevin, you mind showing this nice customer how to kill the coward within?
The Nike Live Strong collection is at Dick's Sporting Goods, the home of Nike training.
Manager Lance to main register.
Better known as the Winter Wonderland. Huntington, West Virginia, the snow continues to fall. They cleared the field about a half an hour before kickoff, but the snow is back. The Toledo Rockets won the toss and deferred, and so Randy Moss and the thundering herd of Marshall will get the first possession of this football game. Chris Merrick is on to kick for the Rockets of Toledo. Both teams finishing at 9-2. Both teams at 7-1. Marshall won the East, Toledo the West. Maurice Hines deep for the Thundering Herd. In their first season of Division I football, up from 1AA where they won the national championship on this field last year. And a line drive kick. We're underway. Out to the 30-yard line, and that's where the Thundering Herd will put it in play. An explosive offense. Chad Pennington, the trigger man, started as a freshman, redshirted last year, great year this year. 36 touchdowns, one short of the NCAA lead this year. His wide receivers, we told you about Randy Moss. Up front, good protection for Pennington. Only 19 sacks given up. John Wade, the smartest and the best offensive lineman. That says Bob Pruitt, the head coach of the Thundering Herd. And a look at Moss, who has a touchdown catch in all 26 of the games he has played at Marshall. Pennington to the air. Going deep, going to him right away. And it's incomplete. And the footing along the sideline, a little treacherous.
Hook and go. They decided to go with the double team. The linebacker comes out from his position to deny. You're going to see right here, he's going to deny the hook area. There's the hook and go. He spins and goes. Love is with him. Strike for strike. Does a great job there with the left hand, warding him off. The ball was uncatchable. Good coverage there by Toledo.
Todd, you look at the field conditions right now, it looks like with this new blanket of snow, it's a bit slippery out there.
Well, it certainly is, but people mistake the idea that this is a disadvantage for the offense. It is not. Offensive people know where they're going. The passing game can go to new heights here if they can take advantage of defensive slippage.
Marshall threw for 306 yards this year. This one's going nowhere. Flags are down as Pennington had to fall on the football.
Looks like he drew a couple of people offsides. The point that I was trying to make with regards to that is one that Bud Grant made years ago after the years that he had coaching in Winnipeg, as you see offsides against Toledo. His theory was is that before the field got too bad that he wanted to take advantage of it because his receivers knew where they were headed. And one slip means a touchdown in the secondary. So he threw early and often in inclement weather.
It cost Toledo 5 yards on the offsides. And so the Thundering Herd looking at second down and five. Both teams have played in this weather. Toledo had a snowy game at Akron this year.
One of the things that they're trying to do here is with a three wide receiver set, they're trying to isolate Moss on one side, the wide side of the field. And that's what they've done again as they did on first down here.
A draw to Doug Chapman, and Chapman breaks loose. Out across the 45 to the 47-yard line. First down, Marshall. Defensively, Toledo, third overall in the MAC. This is a pretty good defense. Jason Richards up front, the best pass rusher. 5 sacks, first team MAC pick. Linebacking quartet, Marcus Matthews, very active. 4 sacks from his outside linebacking spot. And a secondary that right now is just a trio. You'll see more nickelbacks as it goes, and we told you about the matchup. Clarence Love, first team MAC pick, and the man in the spotlight along with Randy Moss.
Now they're trying to do something different. Now they have Moss on the two wide receiver side, knowing that he's going to get man for man.
Chapman off the left side, spun off his feet at the 50-yard line. Rashee Sumter up to make the stop.
Well, one of the things that's happening with regards to as they spread things out is that here. Now look at the people that are in the box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. When you have 7 in the box, that affords the opportunity to run, and that's what Marshall is trying to do. That's one of the problems that is presented with an athlete of Moss's stature. Even though that you might take him out of the game, there are other people that can take advantage.
And Bob Pruitt said that this week. Until we see 8 in the box, we're going to run the football. 2nd and 6. Opening drive, MAC championship. And it's Chapman again trying to pick his way inside Toledo territory. It's a gain of about 2.
Interesting here, too, the decision here, 3rd and about 3. They've had some holes there. Chapman took a little bit too long to pick his hole, or he might have had the first down. Wide side of the field is going to be left. It'll be interesting to see if they go with something underneath, if they have the confidence in Pennington's footing at this point, because obviously he's just not sure of himself.
You saw Matt Valent, leading tackler for this Toledo team. 3rd down 3. Pennington to the air. Moss, his first catch. And it's a first down for the Thundering Herd inside the 30.
One of the things that happened once again, they go with the 4 wide receiver set, and to the left of the 3 wide receivers, they have Moss isolated man for man, asking an awful lot of Love to cover him on the slant route. You can see 1, 2, 3, plant and go. It's the basic slant route. The ball is right there. Difficult pass for Love to defend.
It's like trying to defend Randy Moss on skates for Clarence Love right now. Marshall just inside the Toledo 30 at about the 28-yard line. 1st and 10. Opening drive. In motion, LaVorne Coldclaw. And it's Chapman trying to bounce it off. He's out of bounds at the 26-yard line of Toledo. Doug Chapman, 88 yards per game. 9 touchdowns. They'll throw to him as well. There are a lot of weapons. I would expect Tim Nunez, the offensive coordinator, does not have enough footballs to keep everybody happy on this Marshall team.
Well, Doug Chapman was someone coming into this game who'd had 5 of the last 6 games of 100-yard games. He's somebody that certainly would have gone over 1,000 had he been completely healthy, but he's missed the bulk of 3 games, and as a result, the passing game has been able to flourish for Marshall.
2nd down and 7. Ball at the Toledo 26. Do not adjust your sets. A lot of snow here in Huntington. Pennington to the air for Moss. And Love breaks it up. It's incomplete.
Good coverage on the part of Love. You could see that it was an audible going to the fade route. Love was not fooled with him stride for stride.
And a flag down on the play as well. Offsides. Todd, we talk about traction in the defensive backfield. I would expect in the defensive line that could be a problem as well.
Offside.
Well, it can be.
The 5-yard penalty, replay, second down.
One of the things that's interesting here is I'm not sure that it wasn't Clarence Love that wasn't offsides in that particular situation. He was so close to Moss. You can see right there, right on top of him. Great coverage, and there the flag comes out. With him stride for stride, turns and looks, does a great job.
Chapman around the left side. He breaks loose. He's 10. He dives, and he's out of bounds. At the 3-yard line, Doug Chapman, the sophomore. A nice ball fake by Chad Pennington. And Doug Chapman right on the doorstep.
Rich, one of the advantages you have a big wide receiver, 6'3", 209, and 6'5", 210, is that you have some people that can block downfield. Good misdirection on the part of Moss, and that fools Toledo. Colclaw with a good block, enabling Chapman to get to the outside and get just inside the five.
At the 2-yard line. A 3 tight end set. Chapman again. And this time he's stuffed. Kelly Herndon from his corner position made the play.
And that's really costly now, because that's going to put them back into a position to where they might have to throw the ball, go play action here. And sure enough, Colclaw is coming in, and one of the tight ends are going to come out. I never understand, Rich, one of the reasons why the offenses have a tendency to jam things in. They go with a 2 or 3 tight end. Well, what does that mean? The defense is going to do the same thing. If you've got 3 wide receivers, the very thing that they want, 6 or 7 in the box, that's all they can do. And they've been running so effectively with a 3 wide receiver set. Why not stay with it?
Moss, one catch on this drive. From the 5-yard line, 2nd and goal, Pennington to the end zone, and he overthrows Colclaw. 3rd down and goal from the 5.
But once again, they were not fooled. Colclaw comes in to play the tight end position, and he's triple team. He did a great job there in coverage by Toledo. Here's Colclaw down here. Moss is at the top thinking that that's where they're headed. Well, from the slot position, he runs the out. Toledo's completely unfooled. See all the white shirts around him. Good defense.
Toledo, not an easy team to run against. 2nd in the conference, just 129 yards per game. And Marshall on 3rd and goal from the 5, probably going to put it up. Pennington to the end zone. Caught. No. Incomplete. Gerald Long couldn't hold it.
I'm very surprised on that particular play, because they had Moss isolated one for man for man on the other side of the field. I thought they were going to throw a jump ball. Instead, they go with kind of a short post route. You can see the ball is bobbled there. He did not have control before he went out of bounds in the back of the end zone. And now, the field goal team.
And this is something that rarely has occurred this year. Only the 7th field goal attempted by Marshall. Billy Malasevic, only 2 for 6 this year. And he makes it. Just the 3rd successful field goal attempt all year long. The Thundering Herd on the board. They lead Toledo in the MAC championship.
Are drafty doors and windows forcing you to crank up the heat? 30% of your energy bill is literally flying out the door. Introducing Twin Draft Guard, the double-sided insulating miracle that's guaranteed to create an airtight seal. It's twice as effective because it seals air from both sides of the door. We used a hairdryer to show you how air seeps under the door. Install the Twin Draft Guard to create an airtight seal. Nothing gets through. Patented Twin Draft Guard is so easy to install. Just slide it onto any door. It's that simple. Twin Draft Guard adjusts to any door or window. Cut the inserts to the length you need. Slip them into the cover and slide onto the door. And close the door for a draft-proof seal. Door snakes need constant adjustment. What a pain. But Twin Draft Guard moves with the door. Twin Draft Guard seals almost any door gap on any floor. Wood, tile, linoleum. And it easily glides on carpet. It works on windows too. The flexible double-sided arms block the airflow for an airtight seal. Use Twin Draft Guard on outside doors to block the cold, winds, and snow. Insulate garages and basements. Keep out fumes and noise. In hot weather, Twin Draft Guard seals in cool air to lower air conditioning bills. Adjustable Twin Draft Guard is only $19.99. Call now and we'll double the offer. You'll get two Twin Draft Guards for $19.99. It's guaranteed to lower your energy bills. If it doesn't pay for itself the very first month, send it back for a refund. As a free gift, you'll receive the chrome finish 5-prong over-the-door ceramic hook. No installation. Just slip it on any door for coats, accessories, and more. It's a $30 value, free. Two Twin Draft Guards and ceramic over-the-door hook, all just $19.99. Call now.
Begin saving on your energy bills right now. Call 1-800-811-2080 or go to twindraftguard.com. Order now and you'll get two Twin Draft Guards and the free over-the-door hanger for only $19.99. Call 1-800-811-2080 or go to twindraftguard.com.
ESPN's presentation of the 1997 Mid-America Conference Football Championship is brought to you by Acura, the true definition of luxury, yours.
Rich Waltz, Todd Christensen, Chris Marlowe, Marshall University Stadium, where the Thundering Herd on the board first. A 3-0 lead.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful. Good revival. Isn't this what this looks like?
Yeah.
If you just tuned in and saw this.
You kind of get that feeling, don't you?
I'm roasting the chestnuts, enjoying the heck out of it.
All you need are some lights along the sidelines.
You didn't follow that up with a let it snow, let it snow.
Okay. Got to let the picture tell the story sometimes. It's Romaine Davis. And Davis is out across the 25 to the 29-yard line. The Toledo 29-yard line. Sunday at 4 o'clock. Where's everyone going this postseason? Well, you'll find out. The College Football Alliance Selection Special. Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit. They'll bring you all the matchups. There's going to be some disappointed people, I expect. It's almost getting to be like the NCAA Basketball Tournament Selection Show. Now the Rockets with their first possession. They have a wonderful quarterback in Chris Wallace. One of the great stories in college football. And it's back to Wallace. Man wide open. It's Kreitzberg with a catch. He's to the 30, and Kreitzberg is inside the 25 to the 22-yard line.
Larry Moore, the cornerback, was not fooled by that, but the exact same thing that happened that we talked about is what occurred. Moore ends up falling down. Watch the right of your picture. They're going to go with all the movement, and you're going to see right here, see him fall down right there, and that enables Kreitzberg to be wide open. Give him credit that he's able to bounce up. Take a look. He's going to look in the backfield. He's not fooled. He's backpedaling. He knows what's happened. Now when he turns to run, and I've said this before, when you turn to your left, you've got to go off the opposite foot. Instead, he tries to cut off the left foot. He slips and falls. Big play for the Rockets.
From the 25-yard line, Dwayne Harris, sore ankle and all, in the ball game, and he's down to about the 26-yard line. Larry McLeod made the stop. Chris Wallace, 25 touchdowns, 8 interceptions. He was not the first-team quarterback in the MAC. That was Chad Pennington, and he's got a lot of weapons. One of them is back after an ankle sprain after a 3-week absence, a good tight end in Mike Billick. He'll throw to him. Offensive line, just 22 sacks this year. Jim Bates, it's a very balanced offensive line. Gary Pinkel says he'll run right, left, and up the middle. Second down, 9. Ball at the 24-yard line of Marshall. Toledo's first possession. Wallace's throw. Mel Long with the catch. Long down to the 15, and I think he has the first down. And there'll be a lot of speculation tonight in terms of yard lines and measurements.
Ends up breaking a tackle that enables him to get the first down. The defensive backs are very tentative, about 8 yards off. Watch the catch and look how long it takes for the green, for Moore to come into the screen. Took a long time. Long breaks the tackle, gets the necessary yardage. If people think that just because of the snow it's going to inhibit these passers, they're very much mistaken. Both of these quarterbacks are going to put the ball up.
A 9-yard pickup. Marshall scoring on their first possession. The Rockets of Toledo, who struggled near the end of their regular season, losing 2 of their final 3 games. from the 15-yard line. This is Harris. They did not have Harris for those three games, and Harris, a gain of about three. Defensively, Marshall, tough. Second best scoring defense, B.J. Cohn, 11 sacks, the senior out of Conley, Georgia, 25 sacks for this defensive unit. A trio of linebackers, the most active is John Grace, 5 sacks, 2 interceptions. He took one of them back for a touchdown. And a secondary that had 14 interceptions, best cover man, Larry Moore.
For being the best cover man, he sure has been getting picked on early.
Second down and 8 from the 11. And Dwayne Harris goes nowhere. Jerati Mercer with the hit along with Larry McLeod.
Textbook. That's what they love to see when you're a defensive lineman or a linebacker. When the feet come up and he lands right on his back. Number of green shirts. Look at that. Right at his back. Boy, that's an outstanding play. Good penetration on the part of Mercer, an outstanding nose guard from the D.C. area.
The Marshall defense threw 2 shutouts to end the season. They shut out Bowling Green and Ohio. Toledo trying to get on the board. Third down, 9. From the Marshall 12, Wallace. A good scramble, but he's going down. B.J. Cohn, his 12th sack of the season.
And this is a big sack in a lot of ways. Certainly the lost yardage, and you could see the tiptoeing that both the quarterback and the guys rushing him were going after. But now you're looking at a field goal of beyond 40 yards in these inclement conditions. That is not a good percentage play. Give Cohen credit with his persistence now, an even dozen sacks for him on the season.
The ball is sitting at the 23-yard line. It would be a 40-yard field goal. Hey, Chris Merritt.
Hey, I just realized something. Where's the guy from New England? Remember that, who came out with the Zamboni?
I think he's still incarcerated.
Oh, okay. Well, he can't help.
He was out on parole when he did it.
Difficult conditions to kick when the ball is in the snow. Less ball to kick. The elevation isn't the same.
Merrick, 1 of 5. He won't even get a chance to kick this one. That's a lateral. The ball is still alive.
I can't believe he wasn't down. But the officials didn't call it, so it's going to be Marshall ball at about the 37-yard line, Rich.
Gary Pinkel watching his special teams blow up. Todd Riddle, the holder, never got a hold of it.
Well, let's see Jason Richards' snap. It's actually pretty good, but once it hits the ground, it scoots through the snow. Now, take a look here as he goes to, or we're not going to get a chance to see him go to his right. Now, watch. It appeared right there that he might have been down, but instead it's a backward lateral, as you pointed out. And so the recovery is made, but it's going to be Marshall football when we come back. Still up, 3-0.
Valentine's Day is just around the corner. Will you stand in line for wilting, overpriced roses? ProFlowers has a better solution. Send her the gift of romance she's sure to love. Send her a dozen assorted roses fresh from the field right to her door for just $29.99. Or make her even happier. Send her 18 red roses plus this premium ruby red vase for only $10 more. Take advantage of this exclusive TV offer. Go to ProFlowers.com. Click on the microphone in the upper right corner. Enter mail in the box. Or call toll-free 1-800-FRESHEST and mention TV, and you're ready to send fresh roses to her for Valentine's Day.
Maybe 2 minutes on the computer, click, 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 and you're done. So it avoids a lot of headache and a lot of hassle at the last minute.
Those flowers stay fresh and beautiful a week to 2 weeks.
ProFlowers consistently delivers flowers that are good quality.
This TV offer is $30 less than standard website pricing, but only if you go to ProFlowers.com, click on the microphone in the upper right corner, enter mail in the box, or call 1-800-FRESHEST and mention TV. Go online or call now.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
Every game matters. Some just matter more. Rivalry Week presented by Cisco. Monday at 9, Kansas battles Missouri in the Border War. Wednesday at 9, another Tobacco Road showdown between Duke and North Carolina.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
My laptop offers me the freedom and flexibility to work anywhere, but it's not always comfortable.
Not anymore. Now you can use your laptop comfortably anywhere with the revolutionary PortaBook. It's so easy. Just choose one of the five adjustable setting positions. Place laptop onto the PortaBook, then fasten. PortaBook allows you to set just the right angle for optimal viewing. No more uncomfortable hunching. PortaBook provides better ergonomic positioning to reduce wrist, neck, and back strain. Just look at the difference. And PortaBook raises the back edge of your notebook, providing increased airflow to help prevent overheating. Use PortaBook to protect your lap from a hot computer. Protect furniture from heat damage. PortaBook has convenient storage for your essentials, so it's the perfect workstation anywhere at home.
With the PortaBook, I can enjoy the portability of my laptop with the comfort of a desktop.
And its space-saving fold-up design makes it ideal for computing on the move. No laptop, no problem. PortaBook is the ultimate convenience for hands-free reading, too. Whether you're typing an important paper or mixing a special dessert, PortaBook supports any reading material at the perfect angle. PortaBook makes the ideal clipboard, and it even makes a great music stand.
PortaBook is so practical, everyone in my family uses one.
You can spend hundreds on other notebook stands, but now you can order the versatile PortaBook for the special TV price of only $19.95. But wait, as a special bonus, we'll send you the pocket-sized Wi-Fi finder. Don't waste time with your laptop searching for a wireless signal. Just a press of a button, and the Wi-Fi finder detects the best signal for optimal wireless internet. A $20 value, yours free. Just pay shipping and handling. PortaBook and the Wi-Fi finder, only $19.95. Order now.
Call 1-800-459-0477 to order your personal PortaBook and get the Wi-Fi finder free for only $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Call 1-800-459-0477. Call now.
If you've just joined us, this is not the North Pole. It's Huntington, West Virginia, side of the MAC championship. One quarter in the books. Numbers?
Well, the big play for Toledo in the passing game, Wallace, 3 for 3 and 60 yards on the flea flicker, took most of that. But as you can see, running the ball hasn't been their strong suit as yet. And, of course, that big sack on Wallace that ended the first drive is the reason why you have the zero.
The winner of this football game goes on to the postseason, to the Motor City Bowl on December 26th. That game will be on ESPN. Ball at the 32-yard line. Chris Wallace, the junior, trying to get Gary Pinkel's offense in gear. Toledo with the football at their own 33-yard line. Dwayne Harris. A gain of about 3. A high ankle sprain kept Harris out of the final 3 games for the Rockets. They won just one of those.
Yeah, they definitely need him. He was over 1,100 yards. He was certainly a key to the offense. I mean, Wallace threw for 25 touchdowns, did a lot of good things, but you got to have that guy that can give you 4 or 5 yards of carry, and that's certainly what Harris provided.
You can see that air cast that he's wearing under his sock. From the 35-yard line. Wallace.
A lot of room.
And out of bounds he goes with a first down. Flag down.
I'm wondering here, that looks like it might be in the spot of a hold. Then again, it could be an offside. It looked like B.J. Cohen was clapping his hands, indicating that he thought he got held. But I'm sure that they're going to refuse that one and take the play.
Offsides on the defense. The penalties declined. It's a first down.
That's one of the things that really concerns Bob Pruitt, the mobility and the escapability of Chris Wallace.
Well, right there, what happened is that he had great pass protection, and most of the receivers are on the right side. He breaks out, and even though Barber's able to shove him out of bounds, now before he can get the first. There's mobility for a quarterback is not an underrated asset.
You can see at the top of your screen they're having troubles setting the chains along the far sideline. Ball right now at the 44-yard line. Toledo on the move.
You're sure?
No, but I'm trying hard to sell it. On first and 10, Harris. Down he goes in the arms of Albert Barber. Down to the sidelines, Chris Marlowe.
All right, joining me now, the executive director of the Ford Motor City Bowl, George Perlis. Coach, where is your heavy coat?
That's right. That's what my mother would say. Where's your coat, boy?
The game so far, Toledo and Marshall, your impressions?
Well, it's a good, tough game. It doesn't look like the running game is working for either team. Three-point game, and that's about what it is. It's a tight football game.
The opponent for the MAC, a champion, who's still on the table?
Well, Notre Dame is still on the table. So is Iowa. So is North Carolina State, Ole Miss, Mississippi, and Virginia.
Let's take this play for one moment. Rich.
Thanks, Chris. Ray Curry in motion. Chris Wallace on play action with time. Over the middle for Curry, who makes the catch. And he's still on his feet. He will score. Ray Curry from Chris Wallace. And Toledo is on the board, 56 yards.
Rodgers Beckett is the man in coverage, and once again, because of the tiptoeing and his inability to make cuts, you're going to see right here, take a look at the misdirection as he cuts across the field. Now you can see Curry tries to get with him, but he just never does close the gap. And Curry breaks the tackle right there, keeps his feet, and goes the distance. Big plays in the passing game as a result of this snowy field.
Chris Merrick on for the extra point. He'll try to make it 7-3. This is not a gimme. Remember the 40-yard field goal attempt. Merrick never got a chance. The snap was mishandled. This one is up and through.
Curry able to break through for Toledo in a big passing play. Take a look. He comes in motion, runs the deep crossing route, and because they're in a zone, he's able to find the gap. Now, Wallace, of course, everybody makes an issue of the club feet that he had and his ability to be mobile, but the man has an arm. That is a difficult throw across his body, and you can see right there, number 7 is very pleased with what he's done. He's put his team up by 4.
The marathon was the hardest thing I've ever done. But remember, pain is temporary and quitting lasts forever. You want to feed the warrior?
What?
Feed the warrior 20 pounds! You feed the warrior by training the body to respond to the mind.
Yeah, I was thinking of maybe just getting into a little light cardio, so.
Hey, Kevin, you mind showing this nice customer how to kill the coward within?
The Nike Live Strong collection is at Dick's Sporting Goods, the home of Nike training.
Manager Lance to main register.
Stay focused for the next 60 seconds. That's all the time I have to tell you the truth about HD television. The truth your cable company doesn't want you to hear. Cable wants you to believe they're keeping up with HD capacity. They're not. But DirecTV is. Get the best entertainment and the most HD channels with DirecTV. That includes exclusive sports with games and matchups you won't see on cable. So call now for all your favorite sports, movies, and shows. And you always get your local channels. Do you know what else? Packages start at only $29.99 per month. Plus, call now and ask how you can get 32 premium movie channels free for 3 months. There are no startup costs, no equipment to buy, and professional installation is free. Call now. You also get a free HD receiver or DirecTV DVR upgrade from America's number one HD provider. Time's up. Make the call.
I'm Chad Johnson, all-pro wide receiver, and I am a GoDaddy customer. You can catch me for a couple hours on Sunday, or you can catch me at my website at any time. GoDaddy has everything you need to get online. GoDaddy. GoDaddy. .com names, website builders, hosting, email, you name it. Go get yours and tell them Ocho Cinco sent you. .com name for just $1.99. ChadJohnson85.com from GoDaddy.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
Every game matters. Some just matter more. Rivalry Week presented by Cisco. These games aren't about records. They're not about seeding. These games are about pride, tradition, and bragging rights.
This doesn't get much better than this.
These are the games everyone talks about.
That's the ball game, and what a ball game.
Monday at 9, Kansas battles Missouri in the Border War. Wednesday at 9, another Tobacco Road showdown between Duke and North Carolina. Rivalry Week on ESPN.
12 stones. 45 minutes of love. Adrenaline. I want to see you push from their album, Anthem for the Underdog. I can't control these feelings anymore. Believe it. My heart is racing and I can't seem to get enough. Am I dreaming? Feels like a drug, but I know it's just adrenaline. Go. Just feel it. Ooh, my in stores now. Faster.
Auto insurance wasn't something I used to get animated about until I switched to Esurance.
Paul is an actual Esurance customer. Here we go, Paul.
With competitive rates and quote-by-print convenience, Esurance makes it easy to save time and money on car insurance.
And don't forget, if you ever run into any trouble, special agents are here to help you 24/7.
Who knew I could be so drawn to my auto insurance company?
Take a fresh look at your auto insurance. Get your quote from Esurance today.
Chad Pennington, first team All-MAC. And so far, he's been upstaged by Chris Wallace. Moss with two catches now. Gain of three, second and seven.
There's a slant again.
He's got another one, and he dropped the ball.
And
Toledo's got it. Clarence Love.
Come back with me about 11 years. You remember a play in the playoffs, the New York Giants and the San Francisco 49ers. Jerry Rice catches a slant route. For all intents and purposes, he's on his way to a touchdown, and for whatever reason, the ball comes out. Take a look at Moss right here. Now with that speed, is he gone? He was trying too hard to switch the ball to the other hand and give Love a lot of credit. It looked like Moss was going to get there first, but he hand fights him, elbows him, and gets to the ball ahead of Moss. I tell you what, Clarence Love is living up to the reputation that they talked about earlier. And maybe Gary Payton is not the only glove in town.
They call him the Love Glove, Clarence Love. Randy Moss with the catch. But Toledo forces another turnover. They have the football at their own 33. First carry of the day for Kevin Kidd, the fullback. And Kidd stays on his feet after a gain of about a yard.
Well, I just didn't understand why when he was into the open field that he just didn't tuck the ball and go. It appeared to me that he was trying to switch hands, which just didn't seem to make any sense. And, of course, Moss with that great blazing speed, he had to figure that once he had... You had the opening.
7-3 Toledo on top. On second and eight, it's Dwayne Harris. And he's outside. Harris has the first down and more. And he goes down in Marshall territory. John Grace made the stop, and Toledo is on the move again.
But Mike Lennox is the one that makes the play number 71. What a terrific block he makes at the point of attack, and maybe that's the reason it's going to come back. I just thought that Lennox did a great job at the point of attack.
Offsides Marshall, third time today.
Once he gets to the outside, number 71 is in front, and he just does a great job engaging the man who has contained.
It's a first down.
And that enabled Harris to get the big yardage. Take a look right here. Here he comes, number 71 on Moore. Look at the engaged right there. He has no chance to get outside, and of course, in that case, Moore is the corner. He's the run support. So give Lennox a lot of credit for getting out front and enabling his runner to get the extra yardage.
And Todd, you can really see how valuable Dwayne Harris is to this offense. That throw batted down and incomplete. Let's head to the studios where I'm sure it's much warmer with Chris Fowler.
And while you guys get warmed up at halftime, Rich, we'll have the National Car Rental Halftime Report, a preview of Championship Saturday. We'll hear from quarterbacks Peyton Manning and Scott Frost about their respective ball games, discuss whether Mac Brown should be allowed to coach Carolina's bowl game, and also an NBA update as the debut for Keith Van Horn of the Sixers. Lee and Kirk join me coming up at halftime.
Thanks, Chris. That's an interesting dilemma, a coach that takes another job. I know John L. Smith, the head coach at Utah State, who is headed to Louisville, is going to coach Utah State in the Humanitarian Bowl. But he has already started making plans and recruiting at Louisville. Dwayne Harris trying to cut inside on second down. And he's back to the original line of scrimmage. Maurice Hines made the stop.
Well, with regards to that, I think back to 1989 when, you know, Bill Frieder took the job at Arizona State basketball-wise. Does he want to coach the rest of the season? They said no. Steve Fisher came in and good things happened. In the case of Mac Brown, though, those are people that he's recruited. He has really forged a meaningful relationship with those players. I had a chance to check his interview, and I think that North Carolina really should let him coach that last game.
Third down, 10. Toledo 3 of 7 on third down.
Quarterback draw.
Wallace, down he goes. Larry McLeod.
One of the things that they teach defensive linemen, Rich, is to stay in your lanes, and that negates a play like this. They were anticipating that maybe they were going to come with a blitz and go wild. They find a little bit of a gap and a lot of white. Take a look at the lanes right here by the defensive lineman. They stay in the middle, and he's got no place to go. B.J. Cohen cuts back to the inside, forces him in another direction, and as a result, Larry McLeod, their 128 tackles coming into this game, their main man, is able to get the big loss, big tackle for loss.
Gabe Lindstrom back to punt, and he'll be punting to Randy Moss.
Moss, once again, seems awfully deep.
Lindstrom with a nice kick that just rolls into the end zone. And it's a touchback. They'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. Tomorrow, 11 a.m. on ESPN, College Football Game Day. Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit. They'll bring you all there is to know about an important day in college football. Not a lot of games, but a lot at stake. It's tomorrow, 11 o'clock, 8 o'clock Pacific time.
So what do you think A&M's chances of upsetting Nebraska? Remember last year Texas did it. What do you think about A&M's chances?
Well, strange things happen in conference championships. Here, Marshall was favored in this ball game. In fact, in the local papers, you can see the timeouts remaining. The local papers were advertising trips to the Motor City Bowl, saying that space was filling up rapidly. Wow. Already. Pennington's throw, Coleslaw can't make the catch, and it's incomplete.
I know this wouldn't be very popular with the crowd here, Rich, but the way the offense has been so ineffective for Marshall in the first half, I think it would be wisdom here just to run the clock out and start over again, because Pennington has been inaccurate here over the last couple of series, 8 for 15 and 86 yards.
You know,
and you don't want to make a mistake down here.
And in fairness to Pennington, he's hit on two passes that were later fumbled for turnovers.
Good point.
On the ground, Doug Chapman. Gain of about 8, short of the first down. The clock continues to roll, and the Thundering Herd going without a huddle. Well, now they are going to huddle up. And so I think you're right, Todd. They're happy to let the clock roll.
Well, the crowd's not very happy, but they have to understand that it is, you know, it's a 60-minute game. And you don't want to make a mistake here, and points are at a premium in a game of this magnitude.
Coming up at halftime, the National Car Rental Halftime Report. Chris Fowler and the gang. We'll preview tomorrow. Take a look at the Heisman Trophy hopefuls. And again, Doug Chapman. And that will be the final. No, the clock stops. A flag is down with 12 seconds left.
I certainly didn't expect this. I mean, even with the weather, I thought we were going to have a lot of points and a lot of yards.
We've had a lot of excitement. I mean, a lot of big plays that turned into fumbles and It's been Toledo's defense that has made the big plays.
We have to find the 30-yard line, and then we also have two dead ball fouls.
But most important, never mind the dead ball fouls, because they're probably going to negate
let's
one
find
another.
The 30.
Let's find the 30.
Once they find it, I wonder if they'll stick a big flag in it.
Yeah.
Well, they cleared this field about half an hour before kickoff. It was clean and clear, but the snow continued to fall. And by the time they kicked it off, you were looking at a skating rink.
Well, let's not forget that this is really difficult for the officials as well, particularly marking the balls, you know, when you change at the quarter. I mean, this is really a difficult situation here for the officials.
In fact, we've been told the halftime festivities have been canceled so they can clear the snow. And maybe they put an APB out throughout Huntington. All snow plows report to Marshall University Stadium.
Well, you know, up to this point, I'm sure that if you're Toledo, you don't mind, because things have been going well for them. But of course, if you're a Marshall fan, you're saying, yeah, bring them all out here. Let's clean this thing off.
Chad Pennington and the Marshall Thundering Herd, favorite in this football game. Everyone talked about Randy Moss, but the Toledo Rockets have come to Huntington. They have a 7-3 lead.
Uh-oh, can't find a lid to fit? Fed up wrestling with cling wrap that only sticks to itself? Hi, I'm Chef Tony, and now you can store all your food fresh, fast, and easy with my amazing smart lids. With just a press, you can vacuum seal and store everything airtight so it stays fresh for weeks. Smart lids seal anything in any size bowl, dish, or casserole made of glass, metal, ceramic, or plastic. And when you're ready to serve, just lift the lip. You can hear the vacuum release. Now that's fresh. Look, these strawberries are spoiled rotten after just days on the plastic wrap. But the Smart Lid strawberries are still farm fresh after 2 weeks because they lock out air and vacuum seal in freshness. Leftovers last longer too, saving you money. The Smart Lid seal is liquid tight and holds for weeks. Not even a fall can break the vacuum seal. This is 15 pounds of nuts and bolts, but Smart Lids are made of space-age polymers that are strong and durable and can handle just about anything you dish out. You can go from the freezer to the microwave to the table all in the same dish. Don't mess with this when you can store like this. You'll get the complete Smart Lid set, including one small lid, two medium lids, and one large lid of $50 value for only $10. Call right now and we'll send you a second set free. Just pay handling and processing. And there's more. Order now and you'll also get my jumbo lid free. Just pay handling and processing. You get all 9 smart lids for just $10, but you must call right now.
Call 1-800-896-2311 or go online to buysmartlids.com to order now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
Ouch! Tired of getting nicks and cuts from blades that go ooh, dull after just a few shaves? Now there's an easy way to save your money and your skin no matter what razor you use. Introducing Save-A-Blade, the ingenious razor sharpener that can give you up to 200 perfect shaves from a single blade. Just slide the razor inside, press the button, and in seconds your razor blade is like new again. It's truly like turning one razor blade into 40 brand new blades, saving you hundreds of dollars every year and giving you the perfect shave every time. The same technology used in commercial kitchens to sharpen and hone fine cutlery has now been adapted for the razor. Barbershops have always sharpened and honed their blades for the smoothest shaves, but the razor companies don't want us to know that we can too. Save-A-Blade's secret is our patented micro-honing technology that sweeps across the blade at 60 revolutions per second to sharpen and renew your blade in one simple step. It works on all razors, men's, women's, cartridges, single blades, all the way up to 5 blade razors, even disposables. Independent laboratory testing proved that after 200 shaves, a razor sharpened with Save-A-Blade was virtually identical to a brand new blade. It's like shaving with a brand new razor every time. So why put up with the nicks and cuts from dull blades or spend extra money on those replacement blades that are so expensive when you can save your money and get a better shave with Save-A-Blade? As an added bonus, you'll also receive our deluxe His and Hers 18-piece grooming kit. It includes every grooming tool you need to always look your best. A $20 value, yours free. That's right, you get the Save-A-Blade razor sharpener and our deluxe 18-piece grooming kit, a $50 value for only $19.99. But wait, call now and get our $5 rebate offer. And get all this for only $14.99.
Call 1-800-689-8685 to order Save-A-Blade for $14.99 plus shipping and handling after $5 mail-in rebate. Or send check or money order to the address on your screen. That's 1-800-689-8685.
It's a first down. Toledo, their own 45. Wallace to the air. Unloads it, and a gorgeous throw and a nice catch. Brock Kreitzberg holds on.
One of the things that pro scouts look at is the ability to catch the third receiver. Watch. There's the first receiver. He's not there. Where's the second receiver? He's not there. Great pass protection. He's able to buy time with his feet, float to the left, and just drill that ball in there. Just an outstanding job by the quarterback. The offensive line here is what does the job because you can see that Kreitzberg there comes back to the ball like a good receiver does. Of course, the offensive line enabled the 5 seconds to have the quarterback get out to the left and deliver the ball on the money.
At the Marshall 43, it's Harris. Slips a couple tackles inside the 40, dives out of bounds at about the 37-yard line.
Very underrated part of the offense for Toledo up to this point, not getting a lot of credit. Jim Harding, Chris Williams, Jim Bates, Mike Lennox, and Colin Westrich done a very good job of protecting their quarterback up to this point.
Dave Christensen, the offensive coordinator for the Rockets, told us this week that it's a very balanced offensive line. Usually you ask an offensive coordinator, where do you like to run it? Well, I've got a great left tackle. I've got a great right guard. He said, look, I don't care. We can run it right, left, or up the middle. This one up the middle, and it goes nowhere. Larry McLeod, the hit on Dwayne Harris.
That's the reason why he had 128 tackles up to this particular game. Seen a lot of great inside linebackers this year. McLeod's one of them. You can see it in that face. That's a linebacker face with the big neck thing, you know, and the shoulder pads up like that.
He's a local kid out of Huntington.
At one point, Rich, they were 3 for 5 in third down conversions. The last 4 times they have failed. We'll see what happens here.
Mel Long in motion. On 3rd and 3, Wallace in and out of the hands of his receiver. And it's incomplete. Not a bad throw. Mace Freeman was the intended receiver.
Well, again, they came with the blitz. Man comes in motion. You can see comes underneath. Makes the plant. Freeman comes out. Tough catch, but he's got to make that. It goes right between his hands. And Wallace, with people in his face, delivers the ball on the money.
In any conditions, this would be a difficult field goal attempt of about 54 yards. And in these conditions, you don't even think about it. Gabe Lindstrom will punt it.
Remember last time in the same setting, Rich, they decided to go for it. This time, they're going to play the game of field position.
B.J. Summers is deep. And into the end zone it goes. Touchback, Randy Moss, and the Marshall Thundering Herd will get the football when we get back.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
When you put up a fat head, you're making a statement too big for words. A statement like this. Maybe you need something more. How about the NFL, NBA, MLB, NASCAR? If you can think of a sports-related acronym, we probably got a fathead for you. The biggest names and moments captured at the height of intensity, plucked from the playing field like ripened fruit that can smack you in your ear hole. Nice work, fellas. Hall of Famers, ex-gamers, QB sackers, revitalized Packers. I'm starting to rhyme and I like it. Fathead, a passion that's been building and building, so put it in your building.
Get your favorite fatheads from the NFL, plus MLB, NBA, NASCAR, and more. Go to fathead.com now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
Look at how well these lifting straps work for carrying furniture, appliances, and mattresses. Dollies can damage floors, hand trucks beat up stairs, and don't tug. Mattresses get ruined. You can pick items up by hand, but you have to bend down. These adjustable straps carry items inches off the floor to avoid lifting high. Dollies get stuck in thresholds. These straps lift right over door sills, and not only do they encourage proper lifting techniques, but they also employ leverage, making the pieces you carry feel lighter.
Medically speaking, I would use the forearm forklift because I think it's a safe device. I would prefer my husband to lift furnishings with the forearm forklift instead of by hand because I want him to protect his back.
When we were moving in, we had this huge entertainment center. We had it down the stairs and in the truck in no time.
Each order comes with two straps, instructions, and these grip gloves. They're super durable. Here's how easy it is to use these adjustable lifting straps. Put the straps underneath the item that you're about to carry. Cross them, bend with your knees, insert your arms into the desired strap loops, place your hands flat in front of you, keep your back straight, and lift.
I love the fact that I can use my forearm forklifts to move furniture around, to steam clean my carpets in areas that I haven't gotten to.
Your forearms are a fulcrum of support. These adjustable straps use that fulcrum to your full lifting advantage. In fact, your forearms safely support much more weight than your fingers, which leaves your hands free to stabilize and maneuver the load.
As a builder, moving things like bathtubs or drywall, I can't think of anything that would be easier and more convenient to use, and I think it'd last a long time.
Order now, and we'll include this extension for free. It allows you to add 3.5 feet to your pair so that you can even carry furnishings as big as this. Over 1 million patented forearm forklift lifting straps have been sold for as much as $40 a pair.
Now, through this special TV offer, you get the forearm forklift for only $19.95. This amazing offer includes 2 forearm forklift straps, extension, and grip gloves, all for one low price. Call 800-691-5870 while supplies last. Call 800-691-5870 now.
Marshall down 7-3 in the MAC championship game. Marshall at home at Marshall University Stadium in Huntington, West Virginia. The snow and the ice has made this one rather entertaining. Pennington over the middle. Diving.
Oh, what a head. Oh, my.
Claw.
Oh, yes, indeed. Even on a dry field, I'm telling you, you got to like that catch. He extends himself over the middle, same route as before. Take a look at the extension. All hands catch. Boy, that's tremendous. Trying to do some things over the middle because of the special attention that Moss is getting and knifing between the two defenders. Coleclaw comes up with a fabulous grab.
Third catch of the day for Coleclaw. Marshall now at the Toledo 13.
Fade territory here.
To the sideline, a tumbling catch by Nathan Poole, and a flag is down.
One of the things that should be occurring here for Marshall, because of the way the defense is set up, designed to get Moss offsides once again, that's about the fourth offsides we've seen, is that the tight end needs to get involved. They have four people responsible in coverage to cover the two major people. The tight end can run crosses and hooks all night long because of the middle of the field and the fact that they have to be so conscientious of the other two wideouts.
Marshall not real successful at throwing to the tight ends this year, just 16 balls between the two tight ends.
Yeah, but there's a certain point where you have to say, okay, you know, it's not as if we're asking him to run corners or posts and do anything special. Just sit down in the seams in the zone and take advantage. And of course, naturally, that's an old tight end talking.
Man. I was about to say.
Offsides on the defense, 5-yard penalty, replay first down.
And the replay of first down, the operative word there. Marshall will keep that first down, and it will be first down and 5 If they get inside the three, it's a first down. Chad Pennington's year, a single season MAC record right now. And he's one behind Tim Couch as far as touchdown passes in a season.
Good opportunity here, though, with a three wide receiver set to go with a draw play. That was very effective in the middle of the field. They're set defensively for a pass.
Chapman gets it. Fights his way inside the five, and he's close to the first down. Greg King at the bottom of the pile with the stop.
You know, we mentioned Moss. Everybody is aware of him, obviously. But one of the things that you have to do here is that you've got to win the football game. I'm wondering at a certain point here after that one fade route if maybe Marshall's not a little bit too conscientious of trying to get him the ball. I think that this young man at this point now, if I'm not mistaken, he had 11 carries for 59 yards. Maybe this is a time. This is like a four-down situation to get Chapman the ball. Spread everybody out and get him the ball underneath with only the six in the box, and I think they'll get in the end zone.
63 yards now for Chapman. Second and one. They marked it at the four. Pennington, there's your fade. Moss the touchdown, and the record is intact. 27 straight games. And Marshall has the lead.
And I pretty much know what I'm talking about. That's why I brought up the idea that he probably should run up the middle. I guess when you have a guy that's 6'5", 210 with a 38-inch vertical and runs the 40 and 4.25, you do things that are out of the ordinary. I mean, any other offensive coordinator on the planet on second and one inside the five is going to run the ball, but instead, well, we've got this super talented person who's going to break a record. Let's throw it up and give him an opportunity, and that's what he did. 23 touchdown receptions in a single season in collegiate football. Absolutely unbelievable.
And a slew of records come with that touchdown catch. Malasevich with the extra point. It's up and it's in. And it's a 10-7 Marshall lead.
Well, this is only his fourth catch. Yes, he does get in the end zone. But take a look at the timing. Obviously, Pennington and Moss have done this more than a few times. He's able to escape Love there. And it's a good throw deep. Take a look. Inside move, then back to the outside. Throws over the shoulder. Love has absolutely no chance right there at 5'11". Moss shows the quick feet. This is the thing that sets him apart. 6'5", 210, you're not supposed to be that quick. And, of course, you saw the right hand underneath. Just a little shove to the ribs. Pennington knows he's got it where he wants it. Touchdown. And let's also mention here, you pointed out the fact that Moss, that now ties, as you pointed out. That's the 37th touchdown pass for Pennington, tying Tim Couch for the national lead at the one Division I level.
Randy Moss, a touchdown in 27 straight games, 23 on the season. And Marshall now will kick off. And it will be interesting to see how Chris Wallace and the Toledo offense responds. They moved the football successfully in the first half.
Well, the big difference here is that in the latter part of the second quarter, and of course here on that last particular drive, their inability to convert on third and fourth down has really been a problem. Remember earlier in their touchdown drive, they had like two or three third down conversions.
J.R. Jenkins to kick it. A short hop pickup.
I just don't understand that. I apologize for jumping in the middle. Why don't you kick it deep? Why do you continue to squib kick? Now they're out to the 42-yard line. I mean, that's great field position.
Might not be easy to kick it deep with this field. Sunday, 4 o'clock on ESPN, the College Football Alliance Selection Special. Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit. They will kick deep on this show. Brings you all the matchups in the Alliance Bowl.
Oh, wow.
4 o'clock. 4 o'clock Eastern, 1 o'clock Pacific. No squib kicks there.
That's just a peeve of mine. I just don't understand it.
Dwayne Harris straight ahead. He's out to midfield. And Harris continues to impress. Right at midfield. There's a look at Chad Pennington. Tough to stay warm for the quarterbacks.
You got to give him a lot of credit, though. He made an atrocious throw the series before on that interception. A lot of times that can make you gun-shy. He is, after all, only a sophomore. But he came back, delivered some nice throws down the middle, and of course the touch pass to Moss for the score.
He redshirted last year. Bob Pruitt said they prepared him as if he was starting every game last year when Eric Kresser was here. Play action. Wallace throws it short. His tight end, Mike Billick, who is out of bounds at the 42-yard line. And he took with him someone with a Marshall coat on. I'm not sure if that was a coach or a trainer.
You mentioned that he'd been injured, missed the last three games. He is a key to their offense. Surprisingly, 18 and a half yards per reception for a tight end. That is unbelievable.
Toledo throws to the tight ends, 47 catches amongst their tight ends. You can see it. I'm not sure if this is defense 101A, but the classroom is set up on the Marshall sideline. I guess this would qualify as a final exam. Ray Curry in motion on first and 10 for Toledo. And it's Harris again, bouncing off a big hit, but down he goes. Larry McLeod, the man in the middle for the Thundering Herd.
That's about the third time we've seen him do that. You know, so many times you see guys, linebackers, who make big hits coming from the side. This takes a lot of courage to go head on right here. You know he's coming. Look at that. Just delivers the blow, stays with it, gets him by the ankle tackle. Boy, that's a big time collision.
Ball at Marshall's 41, second and 9. Wallace gonna go down. John Grace again. Second sack for Grace.
They've been doing that play action fake so many times and it's been effective, but this time Grace just didn't buy it. You're going to see number 4. Now watch when the guard pulls out. He's going to go right here. The idea is that he's supposed to get fooled with the misdirection, but he does not. Take a look as the guard pulls out. Now he just goes right for the quarterback knowing, I'm not buying the fake this time. And Grace with a very large loss and a big stack on Wallace.
The fourth time Marshall has been able to get to Wallace, one of them was wiped out by a penalty. Wallace is back on third down and real long. Trying to escape, still on his feet, still with the ball. Wallace throwing, and it's a sliding catch. Mel Long did not make it. Incomplete.
What a great effort, though, by that quarterback. He had no business getting out. He should have been sacked about two or three different times. The escapability, that it of which you made reference to earlier, Rich, quarterback's ability, slides to his left, is motioning people downfield. Now, right there, how does he get out of that? Cohen has him. He stiff-armed him and gets out of it. Throws off the right foot, just couldn't get enough mustard, and the ball right there on the ground. Good call by the official.
I'll tell you how he gets out of it. Great feet.
I knew you were going to say that.
That's what his mother Rita would say.
Moss is deep.
Gabe Lindstrom to punt. He's real deep. You pointed that out in the first half. He's a good 50 yards back there. And a good line drive kick. Moss will take it at the 5-yard line. And here he goes. Out to the 17. And Marshall will get it with a 10-7 lead. Next Saturday, 1 o'clock on ESPN2, the Division III Championship from Salem, Virginia. Last year in the Amos Alonzo Stag Bowl, the finalists, Mount Union and Rowan, and they're in the semis this year. Championship football. It's always fun, the Division II, Division III, NAIA, 1AA.
Rich, we had a flag on the play.
And this will back Marshall up inside their 10. Mark it at the 7.
By the receiving team during the return, half the distance penalty, the first down.
Part of the difficulty, and one of the reasons why I think Moss isn't as effective as a returner, is that's a big body to tackle. You know, it's not as if you've got, you know, one of those 5'9 Smurfs that can cut in and out of tacklers. It's 6'5, 210. That's just too much body to tackle, even with his great speed. Hence the reason why, as you mentioned earlier, why you thought that maybe you didn't have a kick return for a touchdown. I think that's part of it.
He hasn't returned a kickoff or a punt for a touchdown. Pennington going to go to the air from his goal line, going deep. Moss, incomplete. And Clarence Love was on the scene again.
Stride for stride. Clarence Love's got to feel pretty good. That's where you look back and you, that, if you're jawing with the receiver, that's where you look back and you say, oh, I'm sorry, is that right? You're 4.25? Well, what does that make me? Because I'm ahead.
One thing he was ahead of Moss, did a nice job with his body to slow him down.
Now, this is interesting, too, as Moss goes over the top. Isn't it interesting that if a defender does the same thing, it's usually interference, but the offensive player could do it anytime he wants.
That was more contact than on Love's interference.
Yep.
Marshall faced with second down and 10 at their own 7-yard line. Pennington. That one is incomplete. Flags down. And Clarence Love again is the guilty party.
And he feels like he can't get a break. This time it's the right arm that appears to come in a little bit early. But it appears to me he's not having the same level of argument that he did on the other one.
We'll review the evidence in a moment. First team All-MAC pick, Clarence Love. Some say the best cover guy in this conference.
Well, if tonight is any
defensive
indication, I'd have to concur with it.
Spot foul, automatic first down.
Here's a look. You play judge and jury.
1, 2, 3. Here comes the slant route. Watch the right hand as it comes in. Once again, It's the hand around the waist. The hand around the waist was there a little bit too soon, but, you have to wonder sometimes, as you mentioned, is that much of a deterrent? But that's what the official saw, and he dropped the flag, and twice Love's been caught for that.
Bennington going to go deep, hook and go, looking for Moss. He's got it. Clarence, can you catch me? No, he's going to go.
Man.
Flag down. He'll get flagged for excessive celebration on the score.
And why is it? Oh, man. I tell you what. Love, they timed that perfectly. Love is on him man for man. He just came off the interference. He's a little bit frustrated. His mind is distracted. Pennington goes right to him. Moss beats him up with the line of scrimmage, gives him a right to the jaw, gets open on the fade, able to make the catch over the shoulder, and he shows the blazing speed. But what I was about to say, and I don't want to be too personal here, but why isn't success enough? Why isn't it enough just to get in the end zone and score? Why do you have to do that at the end? I just really think that mars an otherwise tremendous athletic play.
If you wear prescription glasses, you know protecting your eyes from the sun can be a real problem. Clip-ons let light shine right in from the sides, and prescription sunglasses cost a fortune. Now there's a better solution. Introducing HD Vision Wraparounds. They're lightweight sunglasses that wrap around your prescription lenses, and they feature our unique HD Vision technology that gives you clarity and enhanced color like you've never experienced before. Just like high-definition revolutionized TV, HD lenses enhance your vision and produce unsurpassed clarity and optical definition. And when you see the color and clarity, you will truly be amazed.
The colors, everything's so vivid. It makes things seem almost brighter.
You know what? These are great, and they are so clear.
These glasses look like really designed sunglasses, and they can start at 200 and go up to 4.5.
The color and clarity are amazing.
HD Vision wraparounds have a modern European styling that looks great, and yet they're durable. You could spend more money, but you can't get better sunglasses.
I love them. Where can I buy them?
On this special TV offer, you can get your HD Vision wraparounds for the incredible price of just $19.99. We'll also include our patented visor clip for your car, a $10 value, yours free. But wait, call right now and we'll also include our night vision wraparounds. Perfect for driving at night. They cut the glare of oncoming headlights, but enhance your ability to see everything else. And they're yours free. Just pay shipping and handling. Every pair comes with our 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not completely blown away, return them for a full refund. Enhance your vision with high-definition color and clarity. Don't wait. Call now.
To get your HD Vision wraparounds for only $19.99, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-401-4178. Or visit us online at hdwraparounds.com. So call 1-800-401-4178. That's 1-800-401-4178. Call now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
Nissan engineers know the backbone of any truck is its frame. That's why the Nissan Titan's frame is fully boxed. Unlike competitors' C-frames that are prone to flexing, our box frame is the strongest truck frame we've ever built. Just one more reason is the type of trucks. The 2008 full-size Nissan Titan. Now get up to $5,000 Nissan cash back or 0.9% APR financing.
Man, that was brutal.
I can't take another nine like that.
Hey, Kitty.
Hi, boys. The usual?
Bra.
Excuse me, could I get another granola bar?
You'll enjoy these.
What's that, 220?
Now they're ready?
Ready to get pounded. Again. Schlesinger raw distance. Made to be pounded.
No matter how demanding my workout is, I'm not done until I finish it with EAS MyoFlex. Taken within 30 minutes after my workout, the high-quality protein in MyoFlex helps me refuel and build lean muscle. That way, I don't waste my workout. Now I'm done. Grab your EAS MyoFlex at a leading retailer near you. Or for your free sample, go to EAS.com.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
Welcome back to the MAC Championship game. Marshall 17, Toledo 7. Rich Waltz, Todd Christensen, Chris Marlowe on a snowy night and a cold one in Huntington, West Virginia. The Marshall Thundering Herd down at halftime, putting 14 points on the board in the third quarter. And now Chad Pennington goes to work in the fourth. Swings it out for Mark Wicks, who makes the catch and goes down hard at the 43-yard line. Matt Valent made the stop.
Well, the numbers are considerably different here in the third quarter statistically. And of course, a lot of that has to do with what has happened in the passing game for Marshall. They only had 145 total yards at halftime. You can see right now their total yards have jumped considerably. 145 of that in the third quarter in the passing game.
Both touchdowns, throws from Chad Pennington to Randy Moss. One of 4 yards, one of 86 yards. Little inside toss to Coldclaw, who breaks loose and is still on his feet. Coldclaw into Toledo territory to the 45-yard line.
We mentioned the fact that both wide receivers for Marshall are big people, 6'5", 210, and 6'3", 209. And as a result of that, they get that yak stat that seems to be so popular now, i.e. yards after the catch. You can see there, Coldclaw does just that, breaking through a couple of tackles and setting up a very makeable third and three.
And Marshall obviously conscious of the clock. They'd like to run as much of it off as they can. Toledo needs to get the football back in the hands of Chris Wallace. And it's a defense, a rocket defense, that has been on the field an awful lot in the second half. Doug Chapman, flags and whistles.
Left tackle moved.
Dead ball, false start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
We were talking a little bit about the crowd reaction there, in so much that, you know, they get excited in the third quarter. But Toledo's still only down 10, and Wallace is very, very capable of creating some big plays on his own if this defense can hold him here.
Bob Pruitt told us this week that his players, including Chad Pennington, are very much accustomed to playing postseason type games. They did it in the tournament in 1AA football. And so this is right up their alley, Todd.
Yep. Nothing new.
They're used to going 12, 13, 14, 15 games deep. Another flag down. This one is broken up. And a diving play by Rasheed Sumter. And flags come down.
Oh.
Late flags from
very
deep
late.
In the secondary.
Very late flags.
We have offsides on the defense, and we also have pass interference on the defense.
Pick your poison.
Well, certainly they're going to take the pass interference because that's for the automatic first down. Coach Pinkel has to feel like he's a little bit snake bit at this point. He can't seem to get a call there when it doesn't seem that obvious. Take a look at the end. Here's the plant coming over the top. Once again, what they see is that left arm over the top. That's what the official sees, and that's when he throws the flag. In this case, Sumter.
Rashee Sumter, third interference call on that Toledo backfield. Two had been on Clarence Love.
Well, that one was particularly costly because third and 8.5. Difficult to convert. You're right. A gift.
And the offsides does not mean a first down. It would have been 3rd and 3. Just inside the 40. Marshall on the move with the lead. Pennington got his man. It's Ricks who pays the price but holds on. First down, Thundering Herd.
Great catch because he knows he's going to get clobbered right in the middle of the field. Pennington throws this a little bit softly, trying to get the touch. Wicks right there is able to brace himself. Sumter drops him, but he's able to hang on to the ball. Nice catch. Watch this right there. Pow, simultaneously, but he's able to hang on. That's where in the film room they go, attaboy. That's excellent. Way to go.
On 1st and 10, Chapman. And that offensive line, that big offensive line of Marshall, starting to wear down Toledo.
Have you ever been in a game where they actually called the flag on that play, which is the offensive line assists the runner, and you know that that's in the rule book, but it never gets called? On this play, Chapman gets stood up at about a 3-yard gain. Now watch all the green shirts that come in to help him. Okay? Busts through the line. Now he's held up. Now watch all the green shirts come in and push him forward. Knocking him forward for the extra yardage.
You know, I think to get that flag, you have to pick the guy up and throw him over the line.
I guess. Well, you know, they were blocking the guys around him, but certainly they had some assistance putting their hands in the back of number 22.
Pennington into the end zone for Mass, and he couldn't get it. Clarence Love with the play.
See, by this point, when things aren't going well, this is when a cornerback really has to raise the level of his game. It's easy when things are going well early on, when he had one catch for 18 yards to style. But now that he's made some plays, is he going to fall down? Is he going to give up? No. Love is with him stride for stride and bats the ball away. I think that shows the resilience of the youngster. And certainly at that position, you have to have some resilience, because I don't care how good you are as a corner, you're going to get beat.
Two pass breakups, a fumble recovery, a forced fumble, and four tackles for Clarence Love. And his night is not done. Chapman spinning close to the first down. He needed three. He may have gained it.
It's going to be interesting that in the papers tomorrow, if Marshall were to hold on and win, you know, Moss will get the headlines, Pennington, you know, for his touchdown passes and all the things that he's done. But the guy that's been moving the sticks here late in the third quarter and the fourth quarter has been Chapman.
Doug Chapman coming in, 88 yards per game. 95 right now on 16 carries. Pennington from the 12, swing pass is incomplete, very close to a lateral, and it will bring up second down.
That's about the fourth time they've tried that play. You know, they've tried it with Cole Claw, they've tried it with Moss, but it's been ineffective. And Pennington's trying to explain to him the angle of things and why that didn't work. He's 16 for 29, 264 yards and two touchdowns. Nothing like an 86-yard throw, though, you know, to beef up your stats, huh?
It was a good throw, but obviously a great run by Moss. A lot of yaks on that one. Yards after the catch. Pennington. From the Toledo 12, Chapman again to the 8. Short of the first down, it'll bring up a rather interesting third down.
Gee, I'm going to go out on a limb and say I think they might throw the fade. But then again, maybe that's too predictable. But when you have an athlete of that caliber, I'd isolate him on the one side, throw the fade, and take a shot at a jump ball.
The football at about the 8, third down and 6. Pennington waiting, throwing, full clock, can't get it. Rashee Sumter on the coverage.
Well, Colclaw was the inside receiver. Moss was on the outside, and Moss drew the double coverage. He has kind of a deep slant route near the end, and you can see right there he's patting himself on the chest saying, that's my fault. Wasn't able to deliver the ball where I needed to. Take a look right here. Moss is going to draw the double coverage. Here are the two people right there. Colclaw underneath right here. He's open. The ball's just a little thrown a little bit too far, even though it appeared that it tough catch.
Boy, for a second, I thought Chris Marlowe went down and went down hard. But it wasn't Chris.
Thank goodness.
Billy Malasevich, his second attempt. And this one is up and good. Marshall University played 11 football games this year and made just 2 field goals, least in the nation. Tonight, they've hit 2, and they lead Toledo 20-7.
How many expensive disposable razors or blades do you throw away every year? 30, 50, more? Isn't it time you got the one razor you can use forever? The Infinity Razor. Twin blades forged from carbon-injected steel and fused with rugged tungsten carbide for a razor that never loses its edge. In fact, if the Infinity Razor ever stops giving you a smooth, comfortable shave, we'll replace it free.
I've been using my Infinity Razor for 5 months.
Even after we use this Infinity Razor to shave this sandpaper clean, it can still shave this delicate balloon.
Shh, don't tell my husband. But I use his Infinity Razor all the time, and he doesn't even notice.
No more dragging, no more nicking, because Infinity is the one razor that stays sharp forever to give you a lifetime of smooth, comfortable shaves.
The Infinity Razor is the best razor I've ever used, and the best money I've ever spent.
How much does it cost for the last razor you'll ever buy? Just $19.95. Plus, call today and we'll include a second Infinity Razor absolutely free. It's perfect for traveling. Or since you'll never need another Infinity Razor, you can give one to a friend.
I bought the Infinity Razor for my guy, and I loved his smooth, close shave so much, I had to buy one for myself.
Now she won't have to, because you'll get a second Infinity Razor free. And that's still not all. Call now, and you'll also get the Razor Sharp Infinity Micro Trimmer, a $15 value, absolutely free. Plus this fogless mirror, a $20 value. That's a total value of over $74. Yours for only $19.95. You'll also get 2 guarantees, a 30-day money-back satisfaction guarantee, and our exclusive lifetime replacement guarantee.
So call 1-800-239-2146 now for the last razor you'll ever buy, the amazing lifetime Infinity Razor for $19.95 plus shipping. Call 1-800-239-2146 and get a second Infinity Razor, the Infinity Micro Trimmer, and our fogless mirror free. That's 1-800-239-2146. Call now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
Oh, this bad boy is sick, man.
You like this, right?
This is bigger than my apartment.
So what about insurance, man?
I'm with...
Bro,
what are you, 19?
Man, get some grown man insurance.
It's time to step up. Your Choice Auto Insurance, only from Allstate. More protection, more rewards, starting day one. Whether you have an accident or not.
Stop! Yo!
See, that could raise your rates with...
You deserve more from your insurance. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
When we had taken the step to meet face-to-face, I was terrified.
When I walked in and I saw her standing over there, she was so beautiful, I freaked out.
Experience what it feels like when attraction is ignited by deep compatibility.
I felt like I'd known him forever.
We sat down next to each other and didn't run out of stuff to say a year and a half later.
It all starts with your personality profile. And right now, you can review your matches for free. eHarmony.com.
Stay focused for the next 60 seconds. That's all the time I have to tell you the truth about HD television, the truth your cable company doesn't want you to hear. Cable wants you to believe they're keeping up with HD capacity. They're not. but DirecTV is. Get the best entertainment and the most HD channels with DirecTV. That includes exclusive sports with games and matchups you won't see on cable. So call now for all your favorite sports, movies, and shows. And you always get your local channels. Do you know what else? Packages start at only $29.99 per month. Plus, call now and ask how you can get 32 premium movie channels free for 3 months. There are no startup costs, no equipment to buy, and professional installation is free. Call now. You also get a free HD receiver or DirecTV DVR upgrade from America's number one HD provider. Time's up. Make the call.
20-7, Marshall on top of Toledo. Rich Waltz, Todd Christensen, Chris Marlowe, and about 30,000 bundled up Marshall fans. And the Thundering Herd now trying to run some clock. Little inside screen for Nathan Poole, who has the catch and is across the 45-yard line out to the 47. The Thundering Herd not being real conservative with this 20-7 lead.
Well, as we pointed out, you know, they've decided at this point to say that we're going to play to win. Pennington, the last time they ran this play, it wasn't as effective because the timing was off. This time it was right on the money. Catching the ball and making the most of his opportunity, Poole cuts back. He says, forget about the traction and forget about the fact of holding on to the ball. You know, he's got it loose out there, but he wants to make the most of his opportunity. Fun to see that. Good opportunity for that youngster.
Well, heck, if you're a wide receiver and your name's not Randy Moss, anytime you can see the football, that's a good deal.
Good point.
Pennington to the sidelines. He's spreading it out again. Gerald Long, the catch, still on his feet. And out of bounds he goes. He's got a first down.
Now, how was he able to stay in bounds with this traction? I mean, that was really impressive. I thought for sure that he'd slide out of bounds there. But take a look here as he cuts underneath, catches the ball. Now watch right here. With the one hand, no less. Balances on the one leg, does his flamingo thing, and able to cut forward and get the first down.
And it's a first down for Marshall as they mark it at about the 42-yard line. Gerald Long caught 17 balls. There's a lot of talent aside from Moss. We talked about it. And the wide receiver core, it's a young group. And with Chad Pennington being just a sophomore, he'll have Long, Poole, and Colclaw to throw to next year. Doug Chapman inside the 35-yard line.
Here's what's impressive. Pennington is on the verge of going over 300 yards passing, and now Chapman just went over 100 yards rushing. Don't forget in the first half, at the end of the first half, total yardage for Marshall was 145 yards. So the offense has really asserted itself here in the second half.
106 now for Chapman. They averaged 445 yards per game. First in the MAC. On second and three, Chapman close to the first down. And Chapman's just a sophomore.
Hey, you mentioned some of the talent coming back. I was going to mention that. If I'm not mistaken, his backup is also an underclassman, isn't he?
You got it. Low Turner. He's a sophomore.
But they are going to lose Mark Zeebank.
Backup quarterback to Chad Pennington. Just two off the offensive line, John Wade and Brian Reed. And I think, and I'm jumping ahead here, that if Marshall does go for the Motor City Bowl, they'll give anybody a game.
Might be fun to watch if indeed the selection committee can procure Notre Dame.
Pennington, Moss makes the catch with Clarence Love all over him.
Now it's interesting at that point when you can see, I don't want to say that's a concession. When Love actually helps Moss up, that has to tell you something. Sure, it's grudging respect, but it's also a situation here where maybe, you know, the fight is just out of him a little bit. 1-2-3, here's the slant route, effective. Once again, the difficulty there is that Love is in pretty good coverage. I mean, he's right there, but that 6'5", 210-pound body is in the way. Go ahead.
150 yards on 6 catches and 2 touchdowns for Randy Moss. Into the end zone, jump ball, Randy Moss, got it! Touchdown! Make that 3 touchdowns.
It's amazing if you're a quarterback how confident you can be with the receiver of that level of talent. The play was completely fouled up. The timing of it was wrong, and Pennington said, you know what, I'm throwing it up there anyway, and let's see what the guy can do.
And Marshall has taken control of this football game. They'll add the point and try to stretch it to 20. Malisevich with the extra point. It's 27-7, and it looks like the Thundering Herd are going bowling.
Now, how many times does a guy actually live up to the hype when he's promoted as he is? You're going to see right here on the slant, the timing is a little bit off, but right now he just decides to throw it up. What the heck? And up he goes, makes the catch, 3 touchdowns. What a night.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
Whoa, tie yellow, ripping around the old whoa tree.
I'm Tony Orlando, and I gotta be honest, I was embarrassed to get this fat. But now, I've lost 103 pounds at the tender age of 63.
Introducing the all-new Nutrisystem Advanced, our healthiest, easiest weight loss program ever, including our Silver Plan, designed for older Americans.
Nutrisystem makes it easy for you to lose weight, and I never feel hungry.
Every perfectly portioned Nutrisystem meal is delivered right to your door, free.
And there's a money-back guarantee. Look, this is a 50 waste. Forget it. It's over. I'm a 34, thanks to Nutrisystem.
And it's affordable. For only about $10 a day, you can enjoy 4 weeks of Silver Meals. Order now and find out how you can get an extra 3 weeks of delicious meals, plus a 30-day supply of our specially formulated vitamins free.
Don't go through another day fat. You don't have to.
Call now to find out how.
The Randy Moss Show, better known as the MAC Championship, continues. 27-7. Marshall on top of Toledo. 3 touchdown catches, all in the second half for that man. He's got 25 on the season now. And don't forget, Chad Pennington has now thrown for 39. Let's go down to the sidelines. Chris Marlowe. Chris?
With me, the commissioner of the MAC, Jerry Apolite. Jerry, your thoughts on Randy Moss and this championship game?
Well, Randy's just an exceptional athlete. You'd think that the weather would slow him down, but he's executed extremely well. We couldn't have a better championship. Unfortunately, the weather was not in our favor, but it's a great setting. We had the best against the best, and it's truly remarkable how both these teams have competed under these circumstances.
How much would it mean to the MAC to play a big-time bowl opponent, say a Notre Dame?
Well, we've never had that opportunity before, and we're looking forward to it. There's a crack and an opening, and hopefully we have that opportunity.
Thanks a lot, Jerry. Congratulations on a great season. We'll see you a little bit later.
Thank you.
Back to you.
Thank you, Chris. Dwayne Harris spinning out to the 41-yard line. And with 6.5 minutes left, a minor miracle, maybe not a minor miracle, must take place for Toledo to get back in it. Hurry-up offense, Wallace from the shotgun, and he goes down. B.J. Cohen got him. Loose ball. It's scooped up.
Paul Totten is the man.
And it's down to the 20-yard line. Totten.
You know, it seems to be a little bit poetic justice for Totten simply because of the fact that he's hustled so much all night without getting to the quarterback, getting a sack. And finally, because of Cohen, he's able to come up with a fumble recovery. Wallace trying to make something happen. Trying to make something happen. He looks. Cohen strips the ball from him. There's Totten who picks it up, wants to make the most of his opportunity, rumbling and stumbling, to use the phrase of an ESPN guy, and down he goes.
B.J. Cohen, 12 sacks now on the season. That's the fourth time they've been able to get Chris Wallace.
It was a personal foul at the end. Some fisticuffs that went against Toledo. So that's half the distance to the goal line down at the 10.
Frustrating night. Frustrating second half for that man, Chris Wallace, who will be back. He's just a junior. Movement and flags. And it will cost Toledo 5.
Oh, they got contact on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
I'm trying to resist the temptation to say when it rains, it pours, so I won't.
Coming up next, NHL Tonight. Certainly this is a setting that Barry Melrose would feel comfortable with. Though I don't think they own a Zamboni here in Huntington. They could have used one tonight. 6.5 left in this one. And Marshall about to increase the lead. Cold claw in motion. And it's Chapman. Chapman is in. Touchdown, Marshall.
Well, that seems only fair. Randy Moss was able to take advantage and get a couple of short touchdown passes, the byproduct of his efforts. And going over 100 yards and having the game that he's had, it seems only fair that Chapman should get a 6. Offensive line asserted itself on that particular play. When the defensive linemen are not able to make contact at the line of scrimmage inside the 5, that's dominance on the part of the offensive line. Chapman, 20 carries, 115 yards, and a touchdown.
Malisevic. 34-7, the thundering herd headed towards Detroit.
Well, all the star players from Marshall have come through. Pennington, Moss, and now Chapman as he's in for the touchdown.
Wouldn't it be great if you could carry all your favorite family photos with you in an album that's the size of a credit card? Well, now you can. Introducing Wallet Picks, the world's thinnest digital photo album that lets you carry all your favorite photos right in your pocket. So they're always right there with you to share and enjoy. Look, it's the size of a credit card, yet it holds over 50 of your favorite photos. It fits right in your wallet, your handbag, or just slip it in your pocket. And once again, all your special memories are right there, ready to be enjoyed with everyone. Perfect for carrying your favorite family and vacation photos, special occasion shots, pictures of your children or grandchildren. Just think, over 50 of your favorite photos right here in this pocket-sized digital photo album. That's easy to take with you. All you do is plug Wallet Picks into your computer and select the photos you want to take with you. It's that easy. There's even a built-in stand and a slideshow feature that changes the photos automatically, so you can proudly display your photos. With Wallet Picks, you can pass around your favorite photos the same way you used to pass around your little brag book. And it's easy to change your photos at any time. Or fill one with all your favorite photos and send it off to someone special for the gift that everyone will enjoy. So why leave all your favorite photos at home when now it's easy to take them with you with Wallet Picks, complete with our 60-day money-back guarantee for just 2 easy payments of $19.99. You'll also receive the USB cable for downloading your photos and our deluxe carrying case, a $30 value, yours free. But call right now and we'll double the offer and give you 2 Wallet Picks digital albums, 2 carrying cases, 2 USB cables, and our 60-day money-back guarantee, all for just 2 payments of $19.99. But you have to call now.
To order Wallet Picks, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-560-4542. That's 1-800-560-4542. Call now.
Hi, I'm Mike Gleason inside the ESPNU studios. Thanks for watching ESPNU. For more information on this program and other ESPN sporting events, log on to ESPNU.com. We'll return to more action in this event after these messages.
Ouch! Tired of getting nicks and cuts from blades that go, ooh! Dull after just a few shaves? Now there's an easy way to save your money and your skin no matter what razor you use. Introducing Save-A-Blade, the ingenious razor sharpener that can give you up to 200 perfect shaves from a single blade. Just slide the razor inside, press the button, and in seconds your razor blade is like new again. It's truly like turning one razor blade into 40 brand new blades, saving you hundreds of dollars every year and giving you the perfect shave every time. The same technology used in commercial kitchens to sharpen and hone fine cutlery has now been adapted for the razor. Barbershops have always sharpened and honed their blades for the smoothest shaves, but the razor companies don't want us to know that we can too. Save-A-Blade's secret is our patented micro-honing technology that sweeps across the blade at 60 revolutions per second to sharpen and renew your blade in one simple step. It works on all razors, men's, women's, cartridges, single blades, all the way up to five blade razors, even disposables. Independent laboratory testing proved that after 200 shaves, a razor sharpened with Save-A-Blade was virtually identical to a brand new blade. It's like shaving with a brand new razor every time. So why put up with the nicks and cuts from dull blades or spend extra money on those replacement blades that are so expensive when you can save your money and get a better shave with Save-A-Blade? As an added bonus, you'll also receive our deluxe His and Hers 18-piece grooming kit. It includes every grooming tool you need to always look your best. A $20 value, yours free. That's right, you get the Save-A-Blade razor sharpener and our deluxe 18-piece grooming kit, a $50 value for only $19.99. But wait, call now and get our $5 rebate offer. And get all this for only $14.99.
Call 1-800-689-8685 to order Save-A-Blade for $14.99 plus shipping and handling after $5 mail-in rebate. Or send check or money order to the address on your screen. That's 1-800-689-8685.
It's been the Randy Moss, Chad Pennington. That show in the second half. This is Wallace scrambling to the 40, and on third down, he's going to pick up a first down. Todd, I want to take a moment just to step back and just to mention where this Marshall football program has been. I mean, you go back to the early 70s, the tragic plane crash that took the lives of 75 players, coaches, staff. They rebuilt the program into a 1AA power. Bob Pruitt winning a national championship last year in what Jim Donnan helped build here. He went on to Georgia. And here they are, their first year of Division I football, and they're headed to the postseason, and rightfully so.
I think that's very impressive. Going 9-2, that is the record that they had had. As you get a chance to see the plane wreck, something that was just catastrophic for the university and the community.
They still have a monument.
And those of you that had a chance to read the article in Sports Illustrated a little while back regarding that some of the players, some of the people involved with that organization still can't come to the games. It's just too hard for them.
There were players and some staff that did not take the chartered flight back from East Carolina, and you're right. They've tried to come to a game. They get to the entrance of the stadium, can't go in.
Well, Bob Pruitt remembers it well, and he takes great pride in the fact that he's has been a part of it for so very many years, and now to have it be at a pinnacle right now, as successful as it has been, it's a great deal of pride for him as well as the community.
Bob Pruitt played both ways for this team. Back in the early 60s, down goes Harris. On a play by Larry Moore. That was a third down play. And on fourth down, Toledo obviously going to go for it. And the Thundering Herd will take their show north.
Grayson on that particular tackle, he's a guy that's had a terrific game. A lot of tackles for loss, a couple of sacks, been all over the field. Again, a guy that you document at the top, who's a terrific linebacker, and he's come through.
Fourth down, six. Wallace in trouble, he goes down. For the fifth time, Paul Toviesi, the freshman. And Marshall will get the football. They can run the clock out and make those reservations.
Well, the very thing that we talked about in the first half has been non-existent in the second half, and that was the protection. The offensive line for Toledo had been very good in making sure that they were keeping people off of Wallace, but in the second half, it's been a different story. The front seven for Marshall has really asserted itself.
Todd, I know you've waited for this. Mark Zeban, the senior, gets a chance to play now. Backup quarterback has watched Chad Pennington all season long. And he'll get a chance on this final drive of the MAC championship game.
Good for him.
Mark Wicks in motion. And it's Lo Turner who drops the ball. It's loose, and it's picked up and then dropped again. And I think Toledo has it. They do. Derek Beckwith came up with the ball. James Ross was chasing it as well.
Well, that's an inauspicious debut for Zeeban, who wasn't able to quite get the handoff. Basic dive play. Can't quite get there. And Turner not able to come up with the ball, and now the circus begins. The ball is stripped, coming up from behind. That's actually a pretty nice catch by Ross, but then he gives the ball back. Actually, it ended up being Beckwith who had the recovery.
And Toledo right back on offense. Wallace going to go to the end zone, and it is almost caught. Brock Kreitzberg almost with a highlight film catch.
B.J. Summers with him stride for stride, though.
You know, that's one thing Toledo has not been able to do is get the football to their wide receivers after early in the first half.
Well, Wallace just hasn't had the time. But again, here's Summers, man for man, gets pushed off a little bit but fights back. Tries and gets the right ball, obviously bounced there. You didn't really see that, did you? That's cute.
On second and 10, Wallace again for the end zone for Mel Long, who makes the catch for a Toledo touchdown. Flags down.
Well, that was great concentration. See what the flag is. Great catch by Long. Took a whack in the end zone and held on.
Personal foul against Marshall.
Was that a late hit? Looked to me like he was just trying to separate him from the ball. Take a look. He looks left. Comes back right. Throws the ball, and let's take a look at Long's catch. One, two, catch. What? But again, the second foot getting down. That's kind of close. I mean, you got to see if you can separate the guy from the ball, but certainly didn't. Long with a great catch.
Chris Merrick for the extra point. It's up and good. A little too late, though, for the Toledo Rockets. Marshall on their way to a bowl game.
Are you ready for the max?
Are you ready for the max?
We're always ready for the max.
Yes!
I'm ready for the max.
Take your car to the max with quality Conoco gasoline. It's specially formulated to help clean fuel injectors in just 5 tanks to help reduce emissions and maximize mileage.
Are you ready for the max?
Are you ready for the max?
Help maximize your mileage with Conoco. Take it to the max.
The marathon was the hardest thing I've ever done. But remember, pain is temporary and quitting lasts forever. You want to feed the warrior?
What?
Feed the warrior 20 pounds! You feed the warrior by training the body to respond to the mind.
I was thinking of maybe just getting into a little light cardio, so.
Hey, Kevin, you mind showing this nice customer how to kill the coward within?
The Nike Live Strong collection is at Dick's Sporting Goods, the home of Nike training.
Well, I was shopping for a new car. Which one's me? A cool convertible or an SUV? Too bad I didn't know my credit was whack, because now I'm driving off the lot in a used subcompact FREE. That spells free. Creditreport.com, baby. Saw their ads on my TV. Thought about going, but was too lazy. Now instead of looking fly and rolling fat, my legs are sticking to the vinyl and my posse's getting laughed at. FREE. That spells free. Creditreport.com, baby.
Offer applies with enrollment and triple advantage.
ESPNU brings you National Signing Day. Time for recruits to commit.
The University of Southern California.
And for the country's top football programs to bring in fresh talent. Get a full day of expert analysis as we break down each signing.
They've got to solidify the quarterback spot.
And predict who's built for success.
This might be the biggest running back recruit in this entire class.
Live coverage begins Wednesday at noon on ESPNU. Presented by 76 with expanded coverage on ESPN.com, ESPNU.com, and ESPN2.
34-14, Marshall on top of Toledo, 3 minutes left. In the fourth quarter of the MAC championship game, Marshall on their way to the Motor City Bowl on December 26th, 8 o'clock, Pontiac, Michigan, on ESPN.
Well, Marshall has the hands team out in anticipation of an onside kick. I just don't think that's happening. And as a result, the poor receiver of the kick is not going to have guys that normally block in front of him. I mean, he is going to kick it deep.
He does. Thomas Maxwell. And Maxwell is out to the 28-yard line. Our National Car Rental players of the game, we start with Dwayne Harris, the Toledo tailback, the junior, 106 yards, and Randy Moss. Big second half. All three touchdowns coming after halftime.
200 all-purpose yards. Got a couple of punt returns.
Don't forget the records, and we talked about his records, but Chad Pennington with three touchdown throws, 39 of them now to lead the nation. He's two ahead of Tim Couch.
Just staggering to think about the 25 touchdown catches. That's
two again. There goes the ball on the floor again as Mark Zeeban trying to get it to Low Turner. They did not hook up on their last exchange.
My batting average is 0 for 2. You can see that he did get a little playing time, 11 for 21. Snaps there. Thought it was an easy handoff. Guess not. You know what? This is, well, that's right. It'll be the bowl game. But I'm thinking in front of the home folks, why does he just run it? Run an option there. Tuck it under his arm. A little rushing stat. What do you think?
Why don't you run down and get the headphones on? And you tell Bob Pruitt that. a misfire by the Marshall offensive line.
Oh, the cadence is different.
They have a dead ball, false start on the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty, second down.
Mark Zeeban has more of a legato cadence, whereas more of a staccato. So it can be confusing to the offensive line.
That's the second opera reference you've dropped on us today. The Gatorade, I don't know if it's thawed right now. That could be painful to Bob Pruitt.
Big block comes out. Knocks him out.
They've got some of West Virginia's finest right now lining up to protect the goalpost. And Marshall will keep it on the ground, keep the clock running.
Oh, here it comes.
It's thawed. Oh, man.
Oh, just what a surprise. It was ice.
That may have warmed him up the way.
He doesn't seem too upset about it.
No. Nope. A great year for Bob Pruitt and his staff.
I'm thinking, and again, I could be wrong. Oh, dangerous. I'm thinking that he might take just as much satisfaction in being 10-2 at this level as he did last year being 15-0.
Absolutely. And he'll get another chance to prove himself against the big boys. They did on the road to West Virginia, had a fourth quarter lead and lost there. Went through the MAC, lost just one game. And Bob Pruitt and the Thundering Herd will go to 10-2, and a MAC championship trophy will reside in the football offices. And the Thundering Herd gonna empty the bench, give everybody a chance to play now.
Or they could be punting. You're right.
I'm wrong.
You know what? I was thinking the same thing.
I know. I was
everybody
watching.
Everybody piled out.
Everyone. Yeah. And Bob said, hey, everybody out there. Flag down.
Well, they did have some new people because he went in motion.
A loose ball. This should be fun.
Nah, we'll come back.
Procedure. They'll have to do it again. 34-14. Marshall about to win this one. Chad Pennington.
We have an illegal formation on the kicking team. That penalty's declined. First down.
So 12 seconds left of this MAC championship game. Bob Pruitt in his second year. The opponent, obviously not named yet, for the Motor City Bowl.
Well, how do you, if it was Notre Dame, you've seen Iowa too as well. How do they stack up?
Iowa is a fun team to watch, and I think an underachieving team this year with Tim Dwight and Tavian Banks. They really missed Matt Sherman, their quarterback, when he went down. I think that not enough people talked about that. And right now, we've got the Marshall faithful into the end zone, and they may as well just call this thing. Bob Pruitt thinks so. He's headed across the sideline. They'll call this football game, and Marshall will walk away with a MAC championship, a 34-14 win over the Toledo Rockets. 34-14, the final score coming up next. NHL Tonight. For Todd Christensen and Chris Marlowe, I'm Rich Waltz. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
Students, they are part of the game, reacting to drama, enhancing energy, reflecting passions. Welcome as ESPN celebrates Student Spirit Week.